Now that is a raptor. And yeah, with that, I come back to a new round of Let's Play World of Warcraft, Dalaran. Yeah, as you can see, I just made my way back from Sentient Village and obtained my new pet. Really satisfied. Looks pretty awesome. A lot better than like our level 20 mount. And yeah, that's quite nice. I also did some banking, selling, and yeah, now we are good to go to level a bit more. Last time we locked off at Gromgol base, and yeah, you didn't miss much. Just me going to Orgrimmar, doing some stuff, and also like getting my mount. And also, in case you noticed it already, I also obtained 2 Heardooms by voting for the server from time to time, and this should increase our leveling speed a bit. So yeah, they're actually a bit worse than our like equipment that we had at that point, but still the 10%, that's what this is about. And yeah, I also went for the leather ones, since I figured, okay, if I ever go for another twink, then this will probably be a rogue, so that I have like a heirloom that I can also use for the rogue, like not only for one character. So, and since the stats are quite fine for a hunter as well, this really shouldn't be that big of a deal. So let's accept some quests now in Stranglethorn. Like level 40 is a really nice level for questing around this area. He sends us to the hinterlands. That will be something for later. But yeah, looking forward to this really cool quest hub we are about to take part in, and yeah, this should be fine. Probably will hit level 42, maybe even today. Planning like this to be a maybe 1 hour episode. So yeah, let's see how things go, and if I can get used to the controls and like to the skill sets, since I'm pretty much still in like the old habit of Awakening WoW. Okay, so as I mentioned in an early episode, the Excelsior questline, really good one, provides you with awesome boots for rogues and hunters, so would highly recommend to go for that. Yeah, also went to the auction house and got another bow, since I really don't like this, what's it called, crossbow. I rather shoot with bows. This is more like a, I guess, fashion kind of thing. But yeah, a personal preference of mine to go with bows as a troll hunter. I also thought about going for the bow of searing arrows. The thing with that was that it was a bit too expensive, to be honest. Like, the one we have currently equipped is already good enough. The Swiftwind, it's a really nice crossbow, like I have to say that. But yeah, the bow of searing arrows is basically level 37, so it's around the same damage as the needle threader, and this one was around 20 gold cheaper. So yeah, that's the reason for that. Okay, we think we go for, yeah, the Platze quest line right now, of course. Killing some pirates. Okay, let's see if I still have everything set like it used to be. Or rather, like if I get used to this controls. But looks fine right now. Oh, and I also tried to obtain the missing Green Hills of Stranglethorn, but I was not lucky. Like, there are still missing 2 pages, and those pages were not in the auction house. So yeah, we still have to wait to complete this quest, I'm afraid. I will check the auction house from time to time from now on. It can be really hard too sometimes. Yeah, get this quest done. I think the sound effects are a bit too low right now. Let's take a look at that. Okay, this is also quite interesting. Haven't seen that NPC forever. Okay, really weird. Probably because of a holiday. Strange. Missing out on some information about this guy or her. So yeah, sorry, can't tell you that much about. Going to kill a giant real quick. This used to be a, like, it's still an elite and it's not as easy, but wow, I have to say this looks awesome. Wow, I love this remodel. Like, the old giants also looked quite nice, but like having a boat as a shoulder piece, that's just really cool stuff. Yeah, I love that. Okay, let's use our burst. Really, this quest shouldn't be too complicated. As a hunter, especially. But yeah, I still have to get crossbows up a bit. Still not complete, so yeah, that's a bit of an issue. We'll be able to use a bow pretty soon anyway, but it doesn't hurt to bring up your quest, like your skills from time to time. Wow, I really like this upgrade, I have to say. Really cool stuff. Okay, so that is done. We go there a bit later, I think around level 41. This is a bit higher level zone than this one, so let's just go for the pirates right now. I really think there's like not that much sound, but maybe it's because I have it a bit low. I hope it's not too loud for you. By the way, in the water right here, watch out for some sort of flasks. Bottles, I should say, not flasks. Sometimes there's like one here with a message in it. Message in a bottle. And yeah. You can get a quest from this, requiring you to go to that island and save a princess. It's an homage to Donkey Kong, I think. So pretty nice if you ask me. Like, Blizzard has sometimes a really cool sense of humor, and like, take Ungaro Crater for example. This is like a whole homage to Nintendo, like with Lincoln and the Mario Brothers, and also the gorillas that drop what's it called in English, barrels. Yeah, they drop barrels. So yeah, I like that. It's not very subtle. It's not very subtle, but yeah, some goofy fun. And the Lincoln's questline probably being one of the longest, like, what regarding traveling. You have to go to Winter Spring and all kinds of places, but it rewards you with I think a boomerang, so that's pretty neat. Oh wow, my pet died. Ooh. Okay. Did not expect that. So seems like I have to be a bit more careful. I thought this would be a walk in the park, but yeah, shouldn't take those guys too lightly, especially not the caster mobs. They can deal quite an amount of damage. Okay, we have this. That's a bit weird. Like, I think this is the quest I was just talking about. I don't know if they like patched it out of Wrath of the Lich King, but I don't think so, to be honest. Because this is the princess, like it's a tauren, a female tauren, and she says, yeah, I'm from Thunderbluff. Maybe this is just a hint, but actually there's like a bottle you can pick up where the actual quest is in, so I guess this is more of a, like a hint to that. Because you can't do the quest by just running over there, you have to really pick up the message in the bottle. So that's a bit weird. Bit uncertain now if they really just cut the quest out or if it's like also part of it. I think page 26 was one of the missing ones, so this could be good. Oh, it's really a lot of damage. They are clumped together in this area, so be aware that you probably pull sometimes a few mobs more than you want to. I guess the melee ones are not that hard, but yeah, those casters are really concerning. Oh wow, I'm sorry guys, I hope that was not like too loud for you. Try to get as far away from the microphone as possible. Like damage wise we are pretty much set. This is a lot of damage right now. Yeah, if there are like two or three caster mobs, then our pet is dead soon and we as well, so we are not unstoppable right now. Let's try to go for a dungeon. I aim to get to like level 43 until we leave this zone, so I can already think about going to the highlands. Really nice questing zone there for Horde players. I guess I will try to nuke this one down right here. What I don't like about the server is that enemies actually can shoot while running away. Like, not shoot, cast spells, that is a bit broken. It's not that big of a deal, but sometimes it can be really annoying. Like, it's annoying enough that they run away, but if you get, like, casted upon while they do it, then this is just a bit infuriating. Got a lot of pages dropping right now. I don't think there's like too many that we need actually, since we really only need two more, but yeah. Oh, the Admiral's hat. I think this is a pattern that could sell quite well. Let's keep those. Okay, so only we need only the Eye of Dizzy right now. This also can be a pain to drop sometimes, so let's see. Oh, and I just noticed, like, from the last dungeon, I didn't even have my crawl on, so that's of course also a big mistake. And yeah, this enemy seems to be bugged out, so let's just go for the Warlock. Lot of casters right here, so I'm not surprised that my pet died last time. Holy shit, did you just see that? Whoa. 322 damage. That was a lot. I wonder if that was like from the... No, it had to be a Shadow Bolt. I was just wondering if it's maybe also the pet who was a bit broken, because sometimes that happens, especially Warlock pets. They tend to be a bit insane. But yeah, I think in this case it was just a very high damage Shadow Bolt coming in. Really should not underestimate those guys. Wow. Okay, looks like we are in the... I can't tell right now if it's the armory actually, or if it's the library. Like the starting area of those two instances, I tend to confuse. Oh, and I should turn off my crawl, of course. Oh yeah, I just remembered I also got Wally and it. Yeah, of course. Okay, this is library. Now I know what I wanted to do. I totally forgot that. I wanted to get a gorilla and then try some AoE farming. But I'm not too like excited about this any longer, since on WoW Awakening I also do a lot of AoE farming right now. So I think I might leave this one behind, like this idea. But for the dungeons, of course, we can use Wally, yeah. Oh, I already have it on my bar, okay. Probably should leave a bit more time for the tank to get aggro. Alright. Yeah, now I remember, like, this is like a thing I planned for a long time actually. Like, to go for some sort of AoE grind build. But let's be honest, I do a lot of this right now, so... Maybe just stick to my trusty wolf at the moment. Yeah, I really need to give this tank more time. Keep doing the same mistake again. Looks like we're actually skipping the boss. No, he's going for it, okay. Or is he? Or is he just trying to like get as much enemies as possible? I keep using the wrong hotkey for my volley. Since on another character I had it always on my like the disengage button I have right now. This was my volley back in the day, so yeah. Still keep confusing it. Okay, so no Loxie apparently. Can't say I'm too sad about this since don't need anything from him. Equip wise we are really good. Yeah, really well set right now. Okay, so let's wait a short second. I don't know, like, I think he doesn't start with swipe, which is a bit odd. He has a really hard time keeping aggro for some reason. But maybe just deal a bit too much damage. I remember the times when people actually like rolled for chests like this. Like right, not that this is anything bad, or like I also just opened them at the moment, but yeah. Back in vanilla, like even the slightest amount of silver or green drop was so valuable that yeah, you had to roll about like over chests. And a lot of groups still do this. Like, I'm not going to say that this completely changed, but to some extent it did. Also have to set a hotkey for my aspects. Let's be honest, this is not the best way right now to activate them. But this is like stuff I always want to go for like off screen and then I just forget it. This is not as good as our current one. This is like a really nice warrior or paladin helmet. I would even go that far and say this is best in slot for PvP purposes, like at level 29. But there could be some better stuff, like with more strength. I think there's like a head with more strength, but still. Really nice armor piece. Okay, so let's wait a short second here and okay, I think now we can go. Okay, we still keep pulling aggro. But not as bad as black before, so. Group is making some good progress, like I'm not concerned that we wipe or anything. Looking good right now, although the tank is dropping quite low sometimes, that's like maybe the only problem that could occur, but other than that I think we are fine here. Like, it's also a very low level dungeon for me, so that's probably also reason why I keep doing as much damage. And I just noticed that the tank is just level 30, like, okay, this actually explains a lot. I was not aware of that, to be honest. Like, I'm really high level and this whole group is pretty low level, so yeah. Level 30 tank in this kind of dungeon is of course not the most easiest thing to do for him, and so yeah. That really explains it. For some reason I like the animation of walking back on the troll, like the new one from the patch I installed. There's something, I don't know, something neat about this, I don't know why. So yeah, probably should have checked the level on our tank first. I really did not want to blame him or anything, but it might have like come across as some sort of criticism when I said that he like loses aggro quite a lot. But this is only because, yeah, the level difference, I'm like 10 levels higher than him right now, so it's really not that easy for him. Could use a new belt soon, that would be nice. But yeah, other than that we are really well equipped right now. Sorry if I repeat myself on that. Yeah. Like, with this pull, apparently also the healer was not quite on his top game, so that's also a reason. Remember when I started playing this game, like items that provided you with, oh, this might be ripe actually, let's see. Okay, let's try to nuke down some enemies. Yeah, looks fine. I think the healer's doing a really good job right now. Let's chuck one of those, keep our distance, and try to bring some of them down. Okay, this one as well. Then let's go on this. Okay, quite low on health right now. I think I will just die for a short second. Okay, and then we are back. Maybe slow this enemy over there so the tank, no, didn't survive. I guess I could have played this better, to be honest. Yeah, this was really a bit panicky from me. Could have dealt more damage there and focused down certain kind of enemies a bit faster. Also, I probably stayed dead for 3-4 seconds too long, so... I guess that's also the problem if you like play on different servers with different kind of rotations and characters, that it's really sometimes a bit hard to get into your into your character again. So sorry about that. It was a big pull, and this group is underleveled to average level, except for me, I'm like overleveled, but yeah, so it's not unusual to die there, I think, with such a big pull. Oh, wrong. But yeah, then again, what was I trying to say? Yeah, I still could have done this better. I think playing like on a higher skill level there would have at least got the druid and me to survive there. So, yeah. Okay, I think we will finish this dungeon and then maybe trying to find like the last eye of the pirate. And yeah, I might play on another server then. Like, I really want to keep the series going, and I'm trying to upload a part here and there for like Dalaran WoW. But, well, for one, I have the feeling it's not quite as popular, like, I don't think too many people want to see it even. And, yeah, then it's also not as fun for me right now, but, yeah, I still want to continue the series, and I will keep playing it, of course. But, yeah, it's like not in the same, but I think I addressed it, like, in an earlier episode as well, not in the same kind of output I did 3 or 4 weeks ago, when there was like 2 or 3 hours of gameplay every day. I can't do that any longer, since I also have to upload some Dota and, well, Awakening or even Valoria, so. My biggest concern also being that Stromgarde is very close. But yeah, I repeat myself, like, this is a topic I already explained in an earlier video, so let's let this aside for now. All right, we are done here. Thanks for group. And let's kill some more pirates then. Those are really nice shoulders, but I prefer the 10% more experience gain. I guess the thing we could probably try to do is like keep our rested XP up, so leveling will, like, if I decide to load make an upload, then at least we level really quick. Sometimes this eye drops like on your first mobs, and then you kill around 30, 40, and it just won't appear. So this is always a bit luck dependent. There's a lot of collection quests, I should say. Those minions don't seem to be overpowered in any sort of way. Just that the shadow bolts deal a lot of damage, but that's intended. I think page 16, that's like one of the pages I recently bought even. To complete a quest, only to realize that not every page I need is in the auction house. Oh, there's the eye, so that's nice. Oh, wrong target. Yeah, a lot of pages dropping right now. Unfortunately, not the ones we need, but that's to be expected. Looking forward to my bow at level 42. Oh, here's the horde side of the Flamekeeper. If I remember this correctly, then this is like a event for itself. I'm not too sure why it's happening right now, to be honest. I always thought it would be. I'm probably just wrong about this, don't quote me on that, but yeah, it's a bit strange with the Halloween kind of holiday around the corner. I always thought this would be like somewhere else, like at another time. Really a bit confused about this right now. Also very nice cloak. And I think we will equip this one. Like, we don't need strength, and okay, it's like we also don't need stamina that much, but I think it's a better stat than strength. And also we got like only one this agility, so I think it's a good thing to pick up. Like, if we get ganked or anything, then it's always nice to have some more HP. Alright, it's like one last quest to give away here, but I will go there later when we continue our quest hub around this area. So yeah, I think this concludes this episode. I will try to keep my rested XP up, so this will be a fast leveling experience. And yeah, I thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and yeah, see you next time. Bye.